Good morning students, I am Nafisa, your social science teacher. Today's video we will discuss about the topic land resources. Before we start with today's topic land resource, let's recapitulate the points we have discussed so far. We have started the topic with the definition of a term resource, followed by interdependence or interdependent relationship between nature, technology and institutions with the help of human being. Then we have discussed about classification of resources in detail. Then we have discussed about in what way the indiscriminate of uses resources leading to major problems in these three bullet points. Followed by we have discussed the definition of the term sustainable development, Rio de Janeiro Earth Summit, Agenda 21, why resource planning is required for a country like India, followed by resource planning and the three steps. First, identification and inventory of resources. Second step, evolving a planning structure. Third step, matching the resource development plan with national development plan. So till this steps to resource planning we have discussed in the previous class. Let's discuss about availability of resources and in what way the history of colonization is showing the importance of resources. Be ready with your textbook students. You can clarify your doubts after the session is completed. Availability of resource is a necessary condition for the development of any region. Suppose we feel that if resource is available, then it leads to the development of that region. But actually, just availability of the resource is not enough. Along with that, we need to have enough technology and institutions. Without their support, the exploitation of resources, that means the extraction of resources, is not possible. Then the development of the resource or the region is not at all possible. So availability of resource followed by efficient technology and institutional support is very much required. There are many regions in our country that are rich in resources, but they are not economically that rich. They are economically backward regions. On the contrary, there are few regions which do not have resources at all, but economically they are very much developed. Even here they are asking you, can you name some resource rich but economically poor regions? If you look at the country India, so if you look at India map here, there are places like Chota Nagpur region, we call it as Orissa, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand. These are the regions where we can find lot many resources. These are all economically rich regions, but they are resource wise lot many minerals are available in this region. That's what we call it as Chota Nagpur region also, but they are economically not that rich. At the same time, if you look at the places like Punjab and Haryana, these are the places where we find we don't find any minerals. The availability of minerals is very meager here, but these two are rich due to the investment in agriculture and due to the implementation of green revolution. So technology and institutions have helped in the development of these two regions. Even here, the history of colonization, it also proves, if you look at the history of the European countries coming and invading the Asian countries, especially Asian and almost European countries have occupied every corner of the world, especially Asian countries. If you like our own country India, if we take, the main reason for Britishers coming towards India is the resources. India is rich in resources, in spices, gold, cotton textile, so artifacts done by the Indians. So almost the resource-rich India has attracted the Europeans who are lacking resources. So the history of colonization reveals that rich resources in colonies were the main attraction for the foreign invaders. It was primarily the higher level of technological development in colonies, in colonial countries. So here what happened, India, though we have resources, rich in resources, but technologically machines first made in European countries, which helped them to exploit the resources of other regions and to establish their supremacy over the colonies. Therefore, resources can contribute to development only when they are accompanied by appropriate technological development and institutional changes. This word proves that. So India has experienced all these in different phases of how exploitation is done. You have studied in your previous classes. Therefore, India in general and resource development in particular does not only involve the availability of resources, but the technology, quality of human resource, and historical experience of the people. All these will influence the development of a resource. Okay, hope you have understood till here. So next, conservation of resources. Do you feel conservation of resources is important? Do we need to conserve the resources? Yes, the answer is yes. Because resources are not, though they are gift of nature, but they are not free gift. Resources are the things which need to be carried forward to our future generations. It is our responsibility. So we need to conserve the resources. So resources are vital for the developmental activity, but irrational consumption means without thinking, consuming it without thinking, and then over utilization of resources leading to problems like social problems, economic problems, and environmental problems. To overcome these problems, resource conservation is very much important. It has been many leaders have thought about it, and they have shared their views also on it. Especially if you take the Mahatma Gandhiji. Gandhiji was also very active in voicing his concern for resource conservation. And he has given a quote also. There is enough for everybody's need, not for anybody's greed. Whatever resources are available in our country, if we use it only to the extent how much we need it, that's enough. It will be available for everyone. But here what's happening, people, instead of using it up to their need, they have become more greedy now. They have become so greedy that they want to save it. They want to save it their next generation. They are storing the things. They are overutilizing. They are exploiting the resources, not just thinking about themselves. They are becoming so greedy that exploiting it. They are over-exploiting it. Irrational use of resources, leading because of the greediness of the people, leading to the exploitation of resources. So, do you understand this? There is enough for everyone's need, but not for anybody's greed. So remember this quotation by Gandhiji. At the same time, Gandhiji also believed in one more concept, that is, he was against mass production. Mass production in the sense industrial production. Production in industries with the help of machines. One machine producing hundreds of things and in a stretch, leading to unemployment of lot many people. If you take the cloth industry, earlier it was cottage industry where almost a whole village is involved in the process of making a textile. But as the time passed on, now the work is done by the machines, making those many people unemployed, jobless. So he was against mass production by industries. Instead, he wanted to replace it with production by the masses. Here mass, M-A-S-S-E-S, masses in the large group of people. Instead of one machine producing lot many things, let many people involved into production so that everyone will be having a job and can generate income. So these two quotations you need to remember. One quotation, there is enough for everybody's need, not for anyone's greed. And he was against mass production, and instead he wanted to replace it with production by the masses. In this box, they have given many other famous personalities who have given the concept of conservation of resource. Like at the international level, Club of Rome has advocated resource conservation for the first time in 1968. At the same time, in 1974, here this box might be important for one mark question, so be thorough with this. So Sumachar, the person known as Sumachar, he believed in this Gandhiji's philosophy and he has written a book known as Small is Beautiful. Many seminal contribution seminars also been held for the conservation of resources, especially we can say one in Brundtland Commission report 1987. And this report, first time 1987, in this report the concept of sustainable development is introduced, and it advocated the means sustainable development as a means of resource conservation. And at the same time, a book also published, which is referred, it is Our Common Future, which highlighted this idea of sustainable development. Another significant contribution we have already discussed is that is Rio de Janeiro Earth Summit held in Brazil in the year 1922. So these are all the contributions on the world level towards resource conservation. Hope you have understood till here. Our next topic is land resource. So our next topic is land resource and land as a resource. Land is also a resource as it is very useful for us. It has too much importance in the lives of human beings. Take for example agriculture, which is required for our survival. We live on the land which perform lot many economic activities. We have land is of utmost important to us. It supports natural vegetation, wildlife, human life, economic activities, transport and communication system. Though here we can use the word land as an asset of finite magnitude, in the sense it is fixed. Land is fixed. On that fixed land, we have to utilize the maximum possible, and people are doing it also. So it is important for the purpose, and we need to plan it carefully. India is a land of variety of relief features. Like in India, we can find mountains, plateaus, and plains, which has been explained through this pie diagram. So we have 43% of plains, and mountains of 30%, and plateau region of 27%. Let's look it in the India map. Mountains. Mountain region we can find in the north part of India, like Himalayan mountains here. At the same time, here we have Western Ghats region and Eastern Ghats region. Vindhya range here, Aravalli range, Vindhya range here. So all these consist of the mountain part of India. Then let's look at the plains part. Plains, we can see plains in the northern plains. This color not getting highlighted. Okay, so in this part we can plain region, plains, northern plains. At the same time, coastal plains also, eastern coastal plain and western coastal plain region. All this consists of plain regions in India. At the same time, now what is left out now? Plateau region. So this central middle part we can call it a plateau, southern plateau region. So overall this area we can call it as plateau region. So mountains, plains and plateau region. And in those areas also, whereas plain area provides us facilities of agriculture and industry, and mountain area it ensures perennial flow of rivers, Himalayan rivers, perennial throughout the year we get water. That's what they are referred to as perennial rivers.